Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This is part two of how to create the look of a vintage matchbook cover design. Picking up from where we left off, Control-click or Command-click the new layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. Click the foreground color and pick a color for the shape you'll place behind your text. I'll pick a light blue. Since I already know its hexadecimal code, I'll type it in. Once you pick your color, click OK or press Enter or Return. Open your rounded rectangle tool and choose pixels. If you're working on version CS5 or earlier, the pixel icon is here. Make the radius 400 pixels and click the gear icon. Tick Unconstrained. Drag the tool over the cover approximately this much, then release. To warp it into a retro shape, open your Transform tool and click the Warp Transform icon. Open the Custom Presets and click Inflate. Change the bend to minus 50. Then press Enter or Return. To adjust its size, open your Transform tool and resize it. Next, we'll create an outline border that complements the background we just created. Make a copy of the background layer and reduce its fill to 0%. Doing this makes the shape invisible, but it'll retain the full visibility of the effects that we'll be adding to it. Double-click the copy to open its layer style window. Click Stroke. The size is 17 pixels. The position is outside. The blend mode is normal. And the opacity is 100%. Click the color box and pick a color for the outline. My color is 87BFF9. Once you pick your color, click OK on both windows. To angle the outline, open your Transform tool and rotate it to an angle you like. Then press Enter or Return. To adjust the size and location of the background and outline together, first, convert the two layers into one smart object. Use your Transform tool to resize it and your arrow keys to slide it. To copy the text effects to our background shapes, go to the Filter Effects icon and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it to the background shapes layer. I like the blur and ripple effect, but for this background, I'd like to get rid of the dot halftone. If you want to hide an effect from a layer, reveal the layer effects and click off the eyeball icon next to that effect to hide it. Next, we'll create retro stars. Make the background shapes layer active and click the new layer icon to make a new layer above it. Click the foreground color and pick a color for the stars. I'm picking a medium blue, 0084FF. Open your polygon tool. Type in 4 for the sides and open the gear icon. Check star and indent the sides by 80%. Press and hold shift as you drag out and rotate the shape until it snaps vertically and horizontally. Then release. Make a copy of the shape. Open your transform tool and go to a corner. Press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in, and then press and hold Shift again as you rotate it 45 degrees. Then press Enter or Return. Merge the two star-shaped layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Make a copy of it and drag the copy to another area on the cover. To adjust its size and position, use your Transform tool. Make a copy of the star and drag the copy to another area. Continue these steps to add other stars to your design. Convert all the stars into a smart object. Name it Stars. Next, we'll copy the layer effects to the stars. Go to the Filter Effects icon next to your text layer, and as you did earlier, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of the effects to the stars layer. Next, we'll surround our text with a clear border that makes our text pop a bit more. Scroll up and Ctrl-click or Command-click its thumbnail to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Expand. Expand it by 20 pixels. Make the background shape layer active and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to it. If you want to angle your matchbook, scroll to the bottom of your Layers panel and make the matchbook layer active. Scroll to the top and shift-click the top layer to make all the layers that comprise the matchbook active. Convert them into a smart object. Then, open your Transform tool and rotate it. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.